Hi everyone, my name is Ellen, and I want to tell you my story about anorexia. I've never been slim. As a child, all my relatives called me a bun, and it amused me. Such a nickname did not seem offensive to me at that moment, but rather it sounded sweet. After all, I loved buns because they were really delicious. When I went to school and met my classmates for the first time, I immediately noticed that I was one of the tallest and largest girls in our class. Even many boys were smaller than me. This made me uneasy. For some reason, I was ashamed that I stood out so much against the general background. Perhaps that's why I stooped, to at least seem a little smaller than I really was. Time was passing, and then I became the tallest and thickest girl in the class. My classmates called me something like a fatty or lard bucket, and no one wanted to be my friend or even sit at the same desk with me. I felt so ugly that I often did not want to look at myself in the mirror. Once I complained to my mom about my weight, but she just made a helpless gesture and said that there are no thin people in our family, and this was our genetics. To be honest, this wasn't the best way to comfort me. This was how I used to live. I was withdrawn and did not accept my body. More than anything in the world, I wanted to become slim and pretty, as I thought that fat people couldn't be beautiful. But I had no idea what I was supposed to do in order to lose weight and look the way I wanted. When I was about 12 years old, I almost came to terms with my fate. I thought that I would live all my life alone, because it seemed to me that no one could fall in love with such a fat and ugly girl. And my family kept saying that I would never become slim. But once, I suddenly saw the light at the end of the tunnel. It was an ordinary day, which was no different from others. After classes, I hurried home to watch a new episode of the Youth series. In it, all the actors were very beautiful, as well as slim, and someone always fell in love with someone else. Life was very active there. My life, compared to the series, was too boring and monotonous. Watching TV shows helped me to make up for the emotions that were missing in reality. After the series came to an end, there was a TV show for housewives. The topic of that program was excess weight and the ways to fight with it. Usually I'm bored watching such shows, but this topic made me glue myself to the screen. In this TV show, I saw several women who lost over 50 kilograms due to various diets. Here it is. Eureka! I urgently needed a diet. In the evening of that day, I was sitting at the computer till night and reading various internet articles about losing weight. It turned out that there were a lot of diets, and choosing the one that would suit me was not that simple. I also realized that our family's eating habits were far from healthy. That's the whole secret of being overweight. Mom was basically cooking very high-calorie dishes with a lot of fats. Also in our family, it was common to eat a lot at dinner. It is not surprising that all my family were more or less obese. All the information that I read was very inspiring. I was also cheered up by the stories of people who lost weight and got the bodies of their dreams. I decided to take action immediately. I didn't say anything to my parents and brother because I was afraid that my family would not support me and would start talking about genetics again. I decided to act secretly, so to speak. The next morning, Mom cooked my favorite pancakes for breakfast. Ugh, I loved them so much. I had to put a lot of effort to eat only a few pieces and not a whole plate, as I did before. For things not to look too suspicious, I put a few pancakes into a package and hid it in my bag. Mom was really surprised that I ate so little for breakfast, but I said that I was already full. The pancakes that I grabbed from the table were given to stray dogs on my way to school. I think they were grateful to me. Since then, I started playing my game, how to eat little food during a day, and at the same time, not to give myself away to my parents. I made use of many different tricks. I told my parents that I ate with my friends after school and was not hungry. But in fact, I did not eat anything except breakfast. I used to hide food, saying that I'd eaten it, and then threw it away. In short, my mind was totally occupied with the new game. And here were the first results visible on the scales. I lost almost 3 kilograms, but it seemed to me that I was still fat and far from being ideal. In order to speed up the process of losing weight, I decided to attend fitness classes 5 days a week. Now every day I rushed to fitness classes after school. Fitness was a lot of fun, and it was interesting for me. The coach was showing different exercises all the time, and we had to repeat everything after him. Sometimes it was very difficult, but I always tried to do my best. Everyone around me began to notice that I was melting. First, my classmates asked how I managed to do it and what my secret of losing weight was. But soon, my family sounded the alarm. One evening, my mother started a serious conversation with me. It was about my weight. Mom asked how I managed to lose weight so quickly and expressed her concerns about my health. I just waved it off and replied that it was all thanks to the sports and reducing the calories eaten per day. Mom asked me not to do stupid things and explained how important good nutrition was for normal development at my age. I promised her to eat better and monitor my well-being, but I rejoiced inside. Very soon, I would achieve my goal, and no one could stop me from getting my dream body. Soon, I noticed in the mirror how my ribs and other bones were sticking out. It seemed to me so beautiful. I guess that never before I felt as attractive as then. I wanted to wear short and revealing clothes because at last I was not ashamed to show my body. But instead, I had to wear loose clothes so that my parents didn't notice how thin I was. I feared that they would force feed me or take me to a doctor. In this case, I would not be able to fulfill my dream, which was about to come true. Due to being happy because I was losing weight, I did not notice at all how my health began to deteriorate. My hair faded and began to fall out. My skin was very dry and constantly peeling. Under my eyes, there were huge black circles. I tried to mask all these trifles, as it seemed to me, without even thinking about what was happening to my body. For some reason, my mom started to increasingly control what I was eating and how much food I was taking. She also talked with me about nutrition. I was really frustrated and annoyed with it. It became difficult to hide the fact that I was eating too little, but a brilliant idea occurred to me. I ate as much as I could, and then went to the toilet and provoked vomiting. I remember that for the first time I was scared to do it, and it was disgusting. But then it became a routine task for me, just like washing my hands. My parents did not notice anything, and I was very happy about it. Then, for some reason, I began to have difficulty falling asleep at night. And then I could not wake up in the morning. I had absolutely no energy for working out, so I had to quit it. My parents realized that something was wrong and decided to take me to the doctor. But I refused and said that I was healthy. Everything changed in one morning. It was very difficult for me to get out of bed. I barely made myself get up. When I went to the bathroom to brush my teeth, I suddenly lost balance and fainted. I woke up on the couch in the arms of my frightened mom. She was crying and wailing, asking me why I had done this to myself. I did not understand what she was talking about, but I didn't have enough energy to ask this. My parents took me to the hospital that day because I was totally unable to resist it. In the hospital, the doctor was just terrified by my weight. It was only 39 kilograms. He said that if we had come to him in a few days, it might have been too late, as irreversible processes in the body have already begun. I was connected to various devices that helped to check my condition. Doctors also took my blood for tests. The results were terrible. He said that with such indicators, I was almost dead. After hearing these words, even my dad could not hold back his tears and started crying. I was diagnosed with anorexia, malnutrition, and bulimia. So my treatment began. In addition to various procedures, doctors also recommended me undergo treatment with a psychologist. At first, I didn't want to be subjected to any therapy. I even cried because I didn't lose enough weight. It seemed to me that I was still fat. Just after two sessions with a psychologist, I suddenly realized that I was close to death and almost killed myself. After a couple of months of treatment, I felt better and gained 5 kilograms. It turned out that gaining weight is even more difficult than losing it. Now I feel much better, and it has opened my eyes. It seemed to me that for the first time, I soberly looked at myself. I am 14 years old and look like an old woman. My skin is dry and wrinkled. The shreds of my hair are falling out. and there are huge dark spots under my eyes. It really hurts that I ended up in such a state and did not love myself. My relatives are very upset and worried about me. Mom constantly accuses herself of not having noticed my problem and having been unable to help me in time. Only I know that Mom is not guilty of what happened. After this story, I realized that eating unhealthy diets is very dangerous, not only for health, but also for life. Never repeat the things that you've heard in my story. My attempts to lose weight made me neither beautiful nor happy, but rather the opposite. Are you satisfied with your weight? Share your answers in the comments. If you liked my story, click on the thumbs up button and subscribe to our channel.